So in this section for mathematics, for courses and articulations, we're going to try to give you some insight on what class you might want to choose for next year. If you're currently in ninth grade and in Math 1, next year you'll choose Math 2. If you're in Math 1 Enhanced, you'll choose Math 2 Enhanced. If you're in Math 2, you'll choose Math 3. And if you're in Math 2 Enhanced, you'll choose Math 3 Enhanced. If you're currently in 10th grade and in Math 2, then next year in 11th grade, you'll take Math 3. If you're in Math 2 Enhanced, you'll take Math 3 Enhanced. If you're in Math 3, you'll sign up for Pre-Calculus. And if you're in Math 3 Enhanced, you can sign up for Pre-Calculus Honors. If you're currently in 11th grade, then next year as a senior, you have all kinds of options you can take. If you're currently in Math 3, then you can choose Pre-Calculus, AP Statistics, Statistics, Sports Statistics, or Financial Algebra. If you're currently in Math 3 Enhanced, you can choose AP Statistics, Pre-Calculus Honors, Statistics, Sports Statistics, or Financial Algebra. If you're currently in Pre-Calculus Honors, you can choose AP Calc AB, AP Stats, Calculus, Statistics, Sports Statistics, or Financial Algebra. And if you're in Finite, then you can choose Financial Algebra, Statistics, and Sports Statistics.
Hello, Stang Nation. This is Mr. Tucker here to talk to you about AP Calculus and what it takes to get there. So first of all, a lot of students ask this question, what's the difference between AB or BC calculus? The idea here is that AB and BC calculus together make up ABC, which would be the full first year calculus at the university level, where AB calculus represents the Calc 1 first semester and BC represents the second semester or Calc 2 at a college. And so these would be the natural progression that you should desire to get to if you're a student who's eventually going to want to be in an all science or engineering field when you go to college and regarding your major. So things like math, biology, physics, or structural mechanical engineering, those sorts of things. So why do you want to take on AP calculus? That's either one, AB or BC. It's going to save you time and money in college. Here at ERHS, we have a very high pass rate. It looks good on the college application. It enhances your chem and physics experience here at ERHS. You're going to get a GPA boost because it's an honors class. And of course, you get that elite math status because you're a calc stud. And it ultimately, it stretches that college semester course, the one semester, and turns into a full year. So your first semester at college for AB, which will be Calc 1, is turning out to be a full year, whether that's junior or senior year here at ERHS at the high school. And why do you want to reach for BC specifically? Is because it's very exclusive. Only the top 1% of ERHS math students make it all the way up to BC calculus. And you're going to get a very solid calculus foundation for college. And of course, again, it completes that full first year, Calc 1 and Calc 2 of your college here in high school. So you're saving money and time again.
For those of you interested in taking stats your senior year, you should know that we offer three different stats courses. First, we offer Stats, which is an entry-level course that will help you learn the basics and prepare you to take a stats class in college. The stats class focuses on many different disciplines and covers a wide range of topics. Next, we have Sports Stats, which is also an entry-level class and serves the same purpose as the regular stats class. The difference is that this class focuses specifically on sports data. If sports is a big part of your life, you may want to consider taking this class. Finally, we have the AP Stats course. This course is a college-level course and can possibly give you college credit. This class is more rigorous and explores the concepts in a deeper, more meaningful way. If you are an honors or AP student or just looking to challenge yourself, this might be the class for you. If you would like more information about AP Stats, listen for details about upcoming presentations during AP Rush.
Regardless whether you are coming from Math 2 or all the way from AP Calculus, AB or BC, everyone should and needs to take Financial Algebra because this is a class where you will learn about how money can work for you. In Econ, you learn about how money works in the world, but in Financial Algebra, you learn about how money works for you personally.
If you have any questions about which math class you should take next year, please talk to your current math teacher.